Well, welcome to This Week at CBN. Today, we're going to go all the way to Israel. I want to introduce you to a couple, and they started a new life in a brand new town. And it was tough on them because it wasn't just a brand new town, they had a brand new country. That's what happened to the Dutch couple in this story. When they moved to Israel, the transition was much more difficult than they ever expected.
Irma and Andres left behind a comfortable life in Holland so they could return to their Jewish homeland of Israel.
In 2003, we came to Israel on vacation. When we got back to Holland, I was homesick for 6 months, homesick for Israel. We started praying about it. We knew it would be difficult financially, but we kept finding verses in the Bible about the Jews coming back to Israel.
Every morning, Andres heads out to work in Herzliya. He's a full-time nurse while Irma runs a medical foot care clinic out of a home office. Both are highly skilled professionals who made a lot more money back in Holland. But the call to stay in Israel was strong, even though Irma didn't know she was Jewish until she was seven.
Most of my family died in Auschwitz. Those who survived the Holocaust were very afraid and didn't talk about our Jewish heritage. When I found out I was Jewish, I thought it was something very special. Now I feel it is a great privilege to live here after we spent so many generations away from our homeland.
To make ends meet, they really needed Irma's business to succeed, but they didn't have enough money to invest in good equipment.
I didn't have what I needed. I thought about closing the business many times, but Andres said we needed to move forward.
When God calls you to move forward, you must move forward. You cannot veer off to the left or right. If you do that, you will get lost.
Some days when they only had enough money to buy food for their children, Irma and Andres fasted and prayed for help. They believe in Jesus Christ and are part of a messianic congregation. CBN Israel works with that congregation. So when we heard about Irma and Andres, we wanted to help and immediately took the family food and new clothes.
It was wonderful to have food for the whole family. And after I prayed about needing new shoes, you gave us new shoes. It's so good to know that Christians from abroad care about us and give to the people of Israel. I know the Lord will bless you for that.
We also knew Irma's office needed some work. So we'd installed a new air conditioner, replaced plastic containers with shelving, and stocked her office with products she can sell. Then we gave her the equipment she needs to do her job well.
I never dreamed I would have all of this. It is a big blessing. My room is so beautiful, and now my clients are very comfortable, so it's easy to share with them about Jesus.
Your gifts have been a huge blessing to us, and they are a confirmation from the Lord that we are on the right track.
There are many Jewish immigrant families in need here in Israel. When people give to CBN, they help families like ours stay in Israel. Thank you so much.
And thank you. If you're a member of the 700 Club, you're part of that blessing. And I want to remind you and pray over you a very special blessing. This comes from Isaiah 58 and verse 10 through 11. This is what happens when you do what just happened to that family. If you extend your soul to the hungry and satisfy the afflicted soul. And that family, they were afflicted. They were hungry. And you extended your soul to them and you satisfied them. Here's the promise. Then your light shall dawn in the darkness, and your darkness shall be as the noonday. And I love this part. The Lord will guide you continually and satisfy your soul in drought and strengthen your bones. You shall be like a watered garden and like a spring of water whose waters do not fail. Realize that, and my prayer over you for the coming year is that the Lord will guide you continually. He'll tell you where to go, what to do. He will be your guide. Let His word be a lamp unto your feet. Well, that's it for this week at CBN.